A Jacksonville mother says her teen would have been graduating in a few months. Instead, they're waiting for an arrest in his murder. Action News Jack's Brittany Donovan shows us the action that mom wants to see and how she and other survivors of violent crime are calling for action.
It was a Sunday afternoon in May. 16-year-old Marquette Clark left home to meet up with friends. 20 minutes later, his mom got a call from her daughter about a shooting a mile from their home.
From the description that they gave of the young man's clothes, she think it's her brother. So I immediately dropped everything I was doing. There's no way to explain that kind of hurt and devastation.
Her son had been murdered, found dead on the side of the road. Today, Julia Gray and other families gathered at Families of Slain Children, releasing butterflies, honoring lives lost to violence in Jacksonville. Each one of them taking time to find their loved ones' names on the memorial wall.
Gray says more and more of the names being added to this wall are children and teens. The list is so long that one panel is at the edge of the Families of Slain Children Inc.'s property. Gray says it's going to take help from the community to stop the list from growing.
The city's crime task force has met dozens of times since its creation in January, and millions of dollars have been allocated to helping at-risk youth through the Kids Hope Alliance. The city is also working with the organization Cure Violence. As Gray waits for an arrest in the May 2018 murder of her son, she says the community also needs to step up.
It has to be a collective, joint effort. It can't be this side doing this and that side doing that. Everybody need to come together.
So no other families have to come here to remember their loved ones. Reporting in Duval County, Brittany Donovan, CBS 47, Action News, Jax.